Griffith is flying into the bend. Florence Griffith.
Bubbling with energy and ability. Mary Lou Retton.
And look at Whittaker go up there. Jubilant. He's won the gold.
Los Angeles, in reality, is a very young city. We are still very innocent. We don't need any whitewashing on our walls.
It should be hands-off murals, whether they're tagged or not.
I couldn't believe that the city had gone so far as to paint out its own murals, because this is our culture. Culture is what defines you.
Here we are today with all these cars going by. The Mural Conservancy has commissioned legendary Willie Herrón, who is not only a muralist but a restorer. Willie has invited muralist Carlos Callejo and Raul Gonzalez to help him to complete this project.
Late 80s, early 90s, both the county and the city decided to adopt a graffiti abatement program that at that time didn't recognize murals as being landmarks of historical interest. They didn't recognize them as being world-class art. They ghettoized them by saying, oh, they're tagged, let's just buff them out. I'm Willie Herrón. I've got about 40 years living in Los Angeles. I was born in Pico Rivera, and right now we're in the middle of downtown. This is the 101 interchange to the San Bernardino, the 10 going east. We're on the east, southeast bound side. We're gonna proceed carefully to go up on the bridge and re-secure the safety line due to the accidents that are pretty high and that kind of stuff happening here. Safety is utmost importance. So we're gonna walk up to the rail there and tighten up that cable.
This mural is one of 10 murals that were done to celebrate the city and the Olympics that came here in 1984. There were 10 artists that were selected for it, and Glenna selected a crew of her favorite top artists who could paint. She designed it and worked on it, and we were all her crew. Originally, you could stand on that side of the freeway and look across and know that the Children's Museum was on the other side of the wall. So it celebrated children, and she had children of all races here and sizes. We had black, brown, Asian, and white. So she was trying to show all the cultures. We all have children.
We gave birth again to this kid that was painted in 1984. When he appeared, everybody was so emotional because so many kids of his generation were so identified with him, because all the boys from that time, from 1984, remember that they wore those tennis shoes, the socks, the shorts, the t-shirt, and they identified themselves as a child of Los Angeles. Nobody asked, nobody wondered, is this kid Argentinian, Chilean, Mexican, Salvadorian, Guatemalan? No, everybody felt identified. Does he have a green card? No, we nobody asked that. This is our kid, a kid born from the walls of Los Angeles, created by Glenna Avila. We come here from all countries, so it is a wonderful experience when we drive by the freeway to see that each one of us is represented, whether you're Latino, whether you're Anglo, whether you're Japanese, African American, everybody is reflected on this wall. Los Angeles is a really young city if we compare ourselves with the European countries. All of us who came to this country, we made this city what it is today. So in a way, this mural is very representative of the rich diversity that we are. And we are together in this, whether we are legally here or not, we are represented here. So this is what the passersby, the drivers see every day. We don't need any whitewash in our city. We need to write our history. We don't have much to talk about in architecture or art. We are unlike Florence or Paris, where you walk, there are walking museums. We can be that too. This is who we are. How are we represented in the city? By the murals. We used to be the mural capital of the world. Why can't we have that again? Let's stop whitewashing our walls.
I have to say that when they painted over it, I was really shocked. I was upset, and I couldn't believe that the city had gone so far as to paint out its own murals, because this is our culture. Culture is what defines you. Culture is the way that you define yourself, and the murals were one of the biggest elements, especially in the Chicano community, to think that they're going to wash out our culture. It was so offensive, and I was so upset when that happened.
Well, part of the problem, I think, with the disappearing of all the Olympic murals was that all the graffiti that actually started to happen, they're basically in most of the neighborhoods in East Los Angeles on the west side, the central side. There's no permanent, how would you say, preservation program. When we walk away, these kids are going to be preserved, but there still needs to be a preservation program where we can actually come back and clean them when they get tagged, and they will get tagged. Tagging's never gonna end. So it's part of our life, it's part of Los Angeles, and Los Angeles, instead of spending so much money on so many other things, really should look at a major preservation program that coincides with graffiti abatement. That's why I think a lot of these got erased, because there was no maintenance program.
So we're not repainting at all, we're just taking off this buff. There's a mural under there. See that? So all the kids that we've done already, they were pretty much what we call in hibernation. They were mummified, covered by this. This is protecting the mural right now. Okay? It has a wax coat on it so that we're able to clean this off. And the parts that are missing, there's little sections here that have little bits of paint. Those are the parts we're fixing. I want to talk about this type of restoration versus what they're giving us as a restoration, which is the vinyl or the material that's being hung. We're going to walk over here real quick. Now, this in here is showing you where they're drilling the holes. They're drilling the holes to put those to hang this tarp up. You have to clean it at least once a month, because it catches a lot of the dust, the freeway dust and the smut. See how it flaps in the wind? That's not what we want. We want to see the murals come back to their full glory without having to be flapping in the wind. This type of cutting corners, not investing into art and just having the machines do all the work, is gonna be our downfall, because this is gonna become, like I said, it becomes trash and it's not biodegradable. So it's toxic trash on top of that. The materials that they use have been known to cause cancer, and the ink that they're using is not archival, so it's gonna fade within a year. Within 2 years, it'll probably be unrecognizable.
I think the city is going towards something that's very temporary. There's no longevity in that kind of artwork. And the fact that it's a facsimile, it's a reproduction of the original art, to me, it's like a master recording when a musician goes in and creates a master tape. That's what a hand-painted mural is. The vinyl is like the record that gets printed from that original recording, and the MP3 that you could download the music. To me, that's what a vinyl is. It's a copy, it's a reproduction, and it doesn't have the same value.
This is what they're trying to call restoration. This is what they're trying to call a mural. That's not a mural, that's not a restoration. That's a piece of cloth hanging on a wall, and it's so easy for it to come down, and it's so easy for it to be destroyed. A mural, like, we're bringing it back after being erased. Nothing's impossible.
How happy are you about the getting rid of the whitewash walls?
I'm excited. I, if anything, I hope this is the beginning of something really amazing, because we have too many gray walls in the city, and there's too much culture for there to be so many gray walls. It doesn't make any sense.
Thank you.
Thank you.
En el barrio se relamen las pancartas, avivando al modelo para.
It's blessed to have guys like this that want to take care of our community and bring these beautiful pieces of art back.
This is a beautiful experience. It's amazing. It's unbelievable. It's a miracle. Feels like an unveiling to me. It's just beautiful.
As he's unveiling the hair, you can totally see the little girl coming back. It's so incredible.
I love her hair.
The hair is the bomb. I feel like we're at an excavation of our history here. Unveiling this is great.
That's amazing.
It's been years since I've seen her face.
Remember this, Margaret?
Yep.
Ah, look at the crazy sound.
Oh my God. Whoa, that's amazing.
What does Los Angeles value, right? And like these children that are coming out of the walls, bringing back people's memory of the last 20 years or whatever. So it's a good thing.
To have the gathering of women was very powerful. That was honorable, very powerful, and I think it's about time. It's almost like the Phoenix bird, women are rising out of the ashes. They're starting to get recognized, and that's and visible. So that's powerful in itself. I'm just so honored that Isabel invited me to this unveiling, because that's what it felt like. It felt like an experience that I never knew. It's like magic. So it was like an unveiling, but it was like magic, and I'm just so happy. The knowledge that Raul and Willie gave us was unbelievable. So I'm just glad to be a part of it.
I would like for you to hear from some of our best artists, our great restorers and muralists, legendary and community muralists that have been working on their own murals, but today they're helping MCLA. But by doing that, they're helping our city. They are working on these monumental projects, but they are monumental themselves. That's the reason that they were here today with them. That's the reason why we have chosen them to be here with us. So let's listen to their thinking of why they're doing this, why they're participating with MCLA, why they're working to make the city what it is today, and let's make Los Angeles the mural capital of the world once more.
I just been really lucky and privileged to be able to, you know, get to meet, you know, great artists like Willie and Carlos and, you know, Margaret and just everybody, you know, just meeting people every day. I meet new artists and artists that have been doing it for a long time. And I mean, the techniques that we're learning here in the restoration is, you know, what I'm learning is more what's the guidelines, what's the actual way of doing it, the real way of doing restorations, because a lot of people might think that restoration is just we come and repaint it, but that's not what we're doing. We're not repainting it, you know? That's something that we're trying to keep the standards of the international and global standards of restoration and conservation, because there's organizations that have been functioning for over 200 years doing this type of work, and they have a guideline and a structure. I mean, they're restoring the murals in Nepal, they're restoring the Mayan murals, and the techniques that they're using is something that Willie here knows, and I'm learning from him, and we're using these same techniques on these iconic murals that made, like he said, made LA what it is known for, which is the murals of LA. And so, I mean, it's like I'm in school. Like, I'm in school all day, every day, learning this, and it's, you know, you just can't pay for that nowadays. You can't find it.
Now we're kind of feeling like archaeologists. Now we're going around and targeting walls and buildings that are still there that we know there's a mural under that paint. And that mural was painted in the 70s or the 60s, and a lot of those buildings are still there. And with the techniques that we've developed, we want to start going around and doing archaeological excavations and bring those murals back.
It is our responsibility, it's your responsibility, it's the responsibility of everybody who is going through these freeways. It's the city, the state, the culture organizations, the artists, the muralists, restorers, the donors, the foundations' responsibility. MCLA cannot do this alone. We need your help. Let's embrace each other, let's work together, and let's stop the whitewashing of our history.